Hello everyone, my name's Kitty Owls Gamer, and welcome back to BuzzFeed. With Halloween just a few short weeks away, or days away, depends when I upload this video, I found some random Halloween themed BuzzFeed quizzes. Not Disney this time, just regular autumn, Halloween, fall stuff. Spooky stuff too. First one is, we know what classic Halloween decoration you are based on how you spend a spooky day. How do I spend a spooky day? In my haunted house? That's not actually haunted. Alright. Pick something spooky to eat for breakfast. Spider pancakes, pumpkin cookies, pumpkin and berry macaroons, or ghost coffee. Alright. Spider pancakes. Yeah, you had me off with spider. Ugh. Pumpkin cookies. Never had them. Pumpkin and berry macaroons. I do not like macaroons. And I'm more of a tea drinker. And I prefer my coffee black with two sweeteners. So, I think I'll go with the ones I've had before. Regular pancakes. I mean, it is spider pancakes. So, and there's blueberries on them. Pick an activity to do. Go to a haunted house, read a scary book, take a walk in a creepy forest, no thank you, pumpkin picking. If we change that to creepypasta, I'm all over it. So read a scary book. Get you in the spooky mood. You're driving home from your activity, from reading a book, I have to drive somewhere to read a book. Could be at the library for all we know. You're driving home from your activity. Choose a song to listen to. Season of the Witch by Donovan. Somebody's Watching Me by Rockwell. Thriller by Michael Jackson. Monster Mash by Bobby Pickett. I have these two on my Halloween playlist for outside when the trick-or-treaters come. But I think it has to be Thriller by Michael Jackson. Good old MJ. It's getting dark out. Choose a horror movie to watch. Trick or Treat, Midsommar, The Exorcist, The Evil Dead. I haven't seen any of them. And I can sympathise with Reagan when she projectile vomits everywhere. So that's what happens to me after I have a raspberry. A whole raspberry. Like on its own raspberry. Raspberry flavours make me queasy. And it's not nice. And it's not worth it at all. So, I'll go with The Exorcist. You're trying to sleep, but a noise frightens you. What is it? The wind howling, someone screaming, dog barking, something tapping on the window. Well, my bedroom's on the second floor, and there's a ledge outside my window. So, if someone's at my window, I'll be pretty scared, but I would also be frightened for someone who's screaming. Technically, I would do the sensible thing and call 999, which I had to do one time, but I'm not going to get into that. So, tapping on the window, because that is flipping terrifying. One thing I hate is seeing pitch blackness outside the window and not knowing what's there. It's creepy. And, well, need I say more? So, tapping on the window. Finally, pick something paranormal that happened to you. The TV randomly turning on to static. Doors opening on their own. Hearing strange noises. Plates flying out the cabinet. Well, Mama Gamer loves a crockery, so it's the poltergeist that should be afraid if that happens. Doors opening on their own. Oh, they do that all the time. It's called a slight breeze. A TV randomly turning on to static. My downstairs TV randomly turns on. I don't know why it does that. Hearing strange noises. Well, out of all of them, I'd say noises you don't know what they are. Plastic skeleton. You're a plastic skeleton. You love chilling with people to the bone. You're low-key and it doesn't take much to spook you. I take offence to that. Okay. Go out trick-or-treating and we'll tell you what your actual mental age is. It's not just for kids and, hey, Mr. Beast is there. Anyway, the last time I went trick-or-treating, I kid you not, I was 20. And that was 5 years ago. But I can explain. My munchkins, when they were done walking around our street, they asked me if I would take them to the street behind ours. And they insisted that I partaked in it. Like, a nice couple gave me a bag when I took them. And one by one, they took their own sweets and then filled my bag. I did pretty well. I mean, it was only a quarter of the way full. It was a Lidl bag. If anyone knows what Lidl is, it's a supermarket for those who don't. But it was very nice of the couple to give me the bag, even though I didn't ask for it. But the kids are like, can she have a bag too? And this goes, here you go. And I was like, not wanting to be rude, I just went, thank you. But I was in the costume, so it... it was fair. And I didn't tell them how old I was either. And it was kind of funny too. Anyway, so take one. A Hershey's Cookies and Cream. Ooh, that sounds nice. Never had it, but sounds good. I like cookies and cream or cookie dough flavoured stuff. Twix, yes. Ooh, Snickers, yes. Reese's Nutrageous. Oh, I love them in this house. 100 grand or Milky Way. That's not the Milky Way I know. Oh, I like the Twix a lot and I like the Snickers. I do like Milky Ways. The British Milky Ways, that is. Ooh. I'll go with the Twix. Not as sweet. Pick another one. Sour Patch Kids. Someone called Markiplier. Rainbow Nerds, Skittles, Ick. Swedish Fish. Button Rice Candy Airheads. I'll go with the ones I've tried. So, Rainbow Nerds. Someone is given away candy by the bag. Grab one. M&M's, Skittles, Dum Dums, Oreos, Heath, Tootsie Roll. I like M&M's, but I prefer the peanut ones, just like my dad. I hate Skittles. Dum Dums, Lollipops. They're not that great. I mean, they're good for shutting a kid up when they talk too much. I like Oreos. Oreos are one of my favourite biscuits. Never had a Tootsie Roll and I've never even heard of Heath. So, Oreos. Chocolate candy bar. Why not? Put more chocolate on the chocolate. Someone's handing out chips. Doritos. Nacho cheese. Oh, it's Cool Ranch. Doritos. Potato chips, cheddar and sour cream ruffles, Cheetos, smart food. Well, here we call chips crisps, as in crisp, a crisp air. Or crisp white sheets. You get the idea. And I've only had Cool Ranch Doritos, so I'll have them. They're really good with dip. Uh-oh, someone ran out of candy. How dare they? So they're just giving out random things. Okay. A fidget spinner? It's 2020, woman. Or man, sir. Madam. Apple, toothbrush, fidget spinner, granola bar, by the look of it. Almond and coconut. Ew, coconut. Mother of Dragons t-shirt or a plush narwhal. I like plushies. I don't have a narwhal one, so 14 years old. So I'm almost 12 years younger mentally. Okay. I don't know how that pans out logically, but okay. Okay, there was no way I could not do this one because I love Build-A-Bear. Dress up a Build-A-Bear for fall and we'll guess your favourite childhood Halloween movie. I've actually got a Build-A-Bear somewhere. She's called Bonnie. Not the purple rabbit. Well, she is purple, but she's a lilac. She's there somewhere. Can't see you, Bonnie.
Oh well.
Choose a critter. Well, this is the dragon one is great, and the black cat, and the teddy bears, but we know me. I have to have the bunnies. I actually have one like that. I call them Fudge. Now a shirt. Ooh. Boo. Pumpkin spice. If you've got it, haunt it. Trick or treat. Smell my feet. No, thank you. I can't read that one. It's too faint. Oh, snap. I like the pumpkin spice woman. The little pumpkin, so cute. And the bottom. Oh, I like the dungarees, but you won't see the lucky little cute pumpkin. And that's cute, but it says for fall or autumn. And we want it for the whole season. So, the denim skirt. Also some undies. Oh yeah, you can't have your teddy bears going commando. No, no, no. Why have I got this hook on? I barely use it, so why not? Alright, the cute little pink knickers. Or undies, yes. We Brits call them knickers, panties, or undies, whatever you call them. And shoes. Oh, I like them, they're cute. And can't forget an accessory. I had flowers for my bear. Microphone, lollipop, hat, mask, pumpkin. The lollipop. If it was my bunny, Murray, he'd be all over the lollipop. A real one, not an accessory. And finally, a Halloween costume. Oh, that one's cute. It's a little urban ranger. The pumpkin. A witch. Werewolf. Day of the Dead. Thing. Oh. The witch. Halloween town. It's okay. It's not my favourite. Pretty much my favourite one is anything by Tim Burton. But I liked it. Debbie Reynolds, bless her, she was great in it. You got Halloween Town. None of the other sequels can beat the original, and it's a place in your heart. You could say that. Okay. I may have got a little bit of Disney magic put in. Everyone has a pair of Halloween Mickey ears that match their personality. Here's yours. I've got a pair of Mickey ears. Or mini ears. Be right back. Okay, it might not go with the hoodie, but the ears nonetheless. Alright. Eerily good stuff. Very funny, Crystal. Very, very funny. Alright. Choose an iconic Disneyland treat. Dole Whip, Giant Pickle, Mickey Beige Net, a Mickey Pretzel, Matterhorn Macaroon, Lightsaber Churro, Turkey Leg Grey Stuffed Gatto, Bacon Mac and Cheese Corn. I really do enjoy a good pretzel. The tag's sticking out. I'll get it. Stay where you are. There. I'm going with the pretzel. I like pretzels. A lot. What do you value most in friends? Humour, kindness, smarts, fun, honesty, money. Loyalty, coolness, support. Kindness. All the way. Pick your favourite Disney sidekicks. Thumper! Okay, screw the rest. Thumper. My boy, Thumper. So good, I love him so much. Don't be surprised, he's a rabbit. Not that I'm biased, though I am. Oh, but I love them. As you can clearly tell. Okay. Which colour speaks to you most? Orange, pink, yellow, blue, white, red, green, black, purple. Pink. I like pink. It's a happy colour. And the very most underappreciated. Finally, oh man. Choose a Disney soundtrack to listen to on repeat. I already listened to all these on repeat. Coco, The Lion King, Beauty and the Beast, Mulan, The Nightmare Before Christmas, The Little Mermaid, Moana, Aladdin, Frozen. Okay. I liked Remember Me from Coco. I liked Can You Feel the Love Tonight in Lion King. I pretty much liked all of them in Beauty and the Beast. Reflection and Make a Man Out of You is my favourite from Mulan. Oogie Boogie Song is my favourite in The Nightmare Before Christmas. Part of Your World and Kiss the Girl from Little Mermaid. Classic. How Far I'll Go from Moana. Oh, that's iconic. Aleti Carvalho's voice. Oh, they must have felt like they won the lottery when they heard her voice. And Prince Ali from Aladdin is a great one. And A Whole New World, if you want to be sweet. And do I have to tell you what my favourite song from Frozen is? It's Let It Go. Oh. It's so hard. How does a Disney lunatic choose? How can I choose? And on repeat? Okay, I'll go with... Well, I could go with Frozen, I could go with Beauty and the Beast because they have happy songs. There's more positivity in Beauty and the Beast. Ooh! Minnie Mouse Halloween Candy Ear Headband. You're super sweet and have a colourful personality. You won't need tricks to look like a treat in this sweet and spooky Minnie Mouse Halloween headband with black sequin bow and a lollipop ears. Available now at shopdisney.com and at Disneyland Resort and Walt Disney World. One day. I've got sparkly Disney. Of course it's Disney. Minnie Mouse ears. Okay, I'm happy with that. They look pretty. They're sparkly. Got sequins on. I pretty much love anything with sequins on. And with that, I'm going to end this video here. I'll leave links in the description below if you'd like to take these quizzes. And tell me what you got in the comments below. And if you liked it, hit the like button and don't forget to subscribe for more. See you soon!